Good evening. Today we are going to see one problem again from principal stresses, that is by both method. So now in this, if we will see the data given, so we have sigma x, we have 120 MPa plus, sigma y minus 80 MPa, tau we have plus 70, and now theta we have to consider with vertical, and we will get this value that is equal to 55 degrees. And now we will substitute the value sigma x 120, sigma y minus 80, tau 70, theta 55. Analytical sigma n, sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 cos 2 theta minus tau xy sine 2 theta. And substituting these values, so we will get it as sigma n equal to 20 minus 30.78 minus 65.78. This cos 110 we will get as negative. And from this we will get sigma n as minus 76.56 MPa. So around 76.56. Then sigma t we have 120 plus 80 by 2 sine 110 plus 70 cos 2 into 55. And we will get this value that is equal to 70 MPa. Now, principal stresses Pn we will have 120 minus 80 by 2 plus minus 120 plus 80 by 2 whole square plus 70 square. And substituting this value, we will get Pn 20 plus minus 122.07. And from this, we will get first value that is Pn 1 that is equal to 20 plus 122.07 gives us 142.07 MPa. And Pn2 we will get minus 102.07 MPa. So 142 minus 102, 70 and minus 76. Then we will go with 1 centimeter equal to 20 MPa because we have 120 and that is minus. So we have to plot on both sides. So we have OA that is 6 centimeters. So we have this as sigma x. Then we have sigma y that will be OB, which will be minus 4 centimeter, we have to plot towards left. So we will plot towards left because minus. Then we have C will be the midpoint of this. And then we will go with tau. So this is sigma Y we have. Then we have this as tau, which will be 3.5 centimeter. And then C will be the center of these two. AB, and then we will plot AA1 upward because that is given upward on right side and BB1 downward. Then we will connect this, which will pass through point C. So we have C already over here and it will pass through point C. And then considering A1C or B1C as radius, we will plot the circle. And then we have this will be the circle. Now after this circle, we have to draw 2 theta, that is 110 degree anticlockwise from this. So we will plot 2 theta 110 degrees and this will be CP line. So now we have this as P line, then we have to draw perpendicular from P on AB, which will be PM. So we have this as PM. Now this plotting is over and now we have to measure the things one by one. First we have that is OM you can see, and OM we have minus 4 centimeters. So we have 20 minus 4 into 20 minus 80 MPa. There we got minus 76 point something MPa. So close we have. Then we have PM. So PM you can see 3.4 centimeter plus. So 3.4 into 20, 68 MPa. There we have analytically we have 70 MPa. Then we can have next, that is ON1. So ON1 we have 7.05 centimeter and that is 140 we have over there, and here we will get it as 141 MPa. PN2 there we have 102, so here we will get it as minus 5.1, and then here also we will get it as minus 102 MPa. So likewise the values of analytical and graphical we are very close to each other. So try to understand these principal stresses by Mohr circle. It's simple. You have to do it properly. And if you do it properly, then you can solve any problem of principal stresses easily by Mohr circle without making any mistake. So we will stop here only. So thank you.